What's up, guys? Welcome back to yet another episode of Talking About Enlisted News. Today we are going to be discussing the new levels for the upcoming campaign, or to the upcoming release of the next major update. As we can see, they are finally going to be adding the, finally be bringing it out of the back files and putting into the main files for the game, for this wonderful Sturmgeschütz 3F, I do believe, which was announced in Germany for the invasion of North Africa. So we should see this in Tunisia as well. Okay, enough previewies. What am I talking about? The final dev blog for the new campaign level arriving in the upcoming update, Burning Sky, Berlin, Tunisia, and Stalingrad. They're doing a 3-in-1 today, boys and girls. To start off with level 34 in the Berlin campaign, you are going to get the Sniper 3. I don't know if these are the first level 3 squads we're getting, but I can tell at least one of them is going to be well sought after. I don't know about this one. Pretty much both semi and fully automatic rifles to both sides. We have AVS-36 for the Soviet Union with a x4 scope, I think. I know the Germans are getting a x4 scope. And they are getting the Sturmgewehr 44 with a 4x scope. And I don't know too much about the Russian one, but the German one I know is capable of switching between fully auto and semi-auto. And I think you can even take the scope off it. Not sure, I haven't tried to do it with my snipers because I like using my scope. Level 35, you are going to be getting armored vehicles. The armored vehicles you can expect to see is the IS-2 and the Tiger 2P. If you go in here, it tells you a little bit about the history and the exact gun. Here it is, 122mm DT, or I'm sorry, D25T. Not DT. And then this one is a 88mm KWK 43 gun. I guess they figured that the T-34's 85mm cannon wasn't good enough for this tank. And all in all, the German tank's superior, because, or at least I think this one's going to be a lot better. That cannon is nothing to smirk at, but that armor, oh, the armor. That, and it tells you that this has the best pen in game in general. Then we go down here to premium squads, and feel free to pause and read through at any time. If you want, scrolling a little bit slower here. Premium squads, because you can't live without them, you are going to be getting assaulters. Now, assaulting squads are very useful, and I haven't actually read through any of them. Looking there, I think I just read down here that it's a Sturmgewehr 45M. I have never heard of a Sturmgewehr 45. So that sounds interesting. And then over here we have the, they're using AS-44s. That reminds me, with that clip, it makes me think of another rifle. I'm not sure if you guys know what that rifle is by chance, but I'm sure you guys could picture it. Oh, here it is. Was a rival to the AK. There we go. A rival to the AK. Which we don't have in game yet. I think they're going to be giving us the AK a little bit early because it was actually designed in World War II. And built. The only thing they didn't have was the clip. So for level 27 in the Battle of Stalingrad, we are getting Anti-Tank Rifleman 3. Or I should say, Rifleman 3, but they have anti-tank grenades on the tips of their guns. Here's the Russian. Here is the German. At level 28, it is going to be a vehicle squad for Battle of Stalingrad. And the Soviet Union is going to be getting a T-34 1941. It's going to be lighter than the T-34 STZ and the Sturmgeschütz 3 Aus F, I believe is the full name. Correct me if I'm wrong. Was originally announced for the Battle of, yeah, for the invasion of North Africa and for the Africa Corps, and then as they first arrived on train to in desert camouflage, and then they were quickly deployed to other places around because that was a replacement for the Stug A. Apparently here it says that the damage of the high explosive on the Sturmgeschütz is going to be really good. And then it says over here that it has the same firepower as the STZ, just less armor and more mobile. Now, of course, we can't go on without talking about the premium squads. They are assaulters as well. Assaulters are very good. These guys look like a bunch of sailors. Look at their hats. I don't know what to think of these guys. Hold on, I'm going to have to go down here and read what kind of squads they are. Jaeger Division and Jaeger Regiment, and you are Marine Infantry Brigade. Okay. 3rd Infantry Battalion. Okay, so I think these guys are the Soviet Marines, and then these guys are just Jaeger Division, so they would be Mountaineers? No, I guess that would be a Mountaineer Division if they said Mountaineers. You have the PPSH-41 for the Soviet Union, and then for Deutschland, or Germany, where does it say? No, here it is. Salmi, submachine gun. I'm probably butchering the name of that. Now, going to the Battle of Tunisia in North Africa. We have Assaulter 3s. Inside the Assaulter 3s, we have the... That looks like a Tommy gun. Or, I should say, Tommy gun. Thompson with a drum magazine. Carries a lot of ammo. Over here, we have the... Motorized Division. Infantry. And infantry regiment. Here we have infantry division with infantry brigade. Let's go ahead and look at the pictures. Very nice Italian uniform. Very nice gun. Ooh, look at the details on there. Hold on, let me go back over here. I think they put more detail on this. And then for the Italians, they are getting the Beretta M38. With a larger magazine that holds 40 bullets. That's going to be a good gun. Well, both of them are. That one's going to hold up to 50 shots. Yeah, this one carries 50 rounds. Now, aviation is what you're getting at level 34 for the Battle of Tunisia. For the British, they are going to be getting a Spitfire. And for the Germans, they are getting a 109. I believe it's a 109 F4. Yeah, I was going to say it looks like an F. Okay, this one's going to be a Spitfire Mark 5C Trupp. For the Germans, they are getting the ME109 F4 Tropical. The Tropical just means that they have an extended filter somewhere on there. But at least from what I understood of the German one. Or German meaning for tropical means that it has a sand filter somewhere on the aircraft to ensure sand doesn't go in. So, looking through here. Very nice. Now, the premium squads. I think I did read through these ones. Yeah, I did read these ones. The British are getting the... Hold on, let me get the exact name. FB Mark 6, my bad. They are getting the Mosquito Mark 6. And then for the Germans, or more accurately the Italians, they are getting a wonderful aircraft by the name of Breda 88. It's almost like they name everything Breda. Well, Breda, yeah, isn't this called a Breda? Yeah, that's Breta, Breta. And what's this one? Breda. Okay, so rather than Breda, this one's Breda. And that one's Breda. I'm sure I'm going to make a lot of Italians angry with that, so please forgive me. Pretty much the main difference is this gets a 500-kilogram bomb and is very fast. Has decent machine guns as well. This has better machine guns, or cannons. Carries 2 or 3, pretty sure it said 3 on here. Yeah, it says 3 right here. 3 100-kilogram bombs. At once. So that is it, guys. These are all the new vehicles coming to the campaign. You have the Tiger II, the IS-1, or because I speak English, technically it would be JS-1. Because Joseph Stalin, and because I speak English, yeah. Fun fact. I guess I'll go looking through all the pictures in case anybody missed anything. I really do think that those premium squads are going to be pretty good, though. I'm kind of tempted to buy this myself. I just noticed that has a little hatch, or I should say, has a little viewport there. Usually, it's the fold-up vision port, from what I've seen. Well, guys, I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Check out my Discord. I'm planning on doing a event coming soon. So, and that will be where we communicate. Outside of that, I also post other news there about various things and updates about videos, etc. So I will catch you guys next time. Peace.